Greetings, Eric Bakker, naturopath from New Zealand. Thanks for checking out my video. I'm going to be doing a series of five videos right now, which I call the key indicator videos. So when you look at these videos, I'd like you to look at all five of these, because these are five particular topics which are going to show you if you're really predisposed towards candida, how big the problem is. So when you check these videos out, you're going to get a good feeling whether you really have an issue with candida, you know, or bacterial parasites or bugs like this in general. So the five videos are basically going to be, we're going to look at past medications and treatment history. That's one. Multiple positive symptom matches is two. Food cravings is three. Digestive conditions is four. And emotional, mental and physical warning signs will be five. So this is the first video and we're going to focus on past medication and treatment history. So if you're watching this video right now, and you think you really have got a problem with candida, you know, or bacteria, or you know, other type of gut issues or systemic issues, I want you to think carefully about the past kind of treatments that you've had, generally from a medical practitioner. Have you been involved in taking medications, short-term or long-term? Particularly if you've noticed when you took the medications, you started developing problems thereafter, requiring either more medications or developing symptoms which are requiring medications, etc. That's A. And B, did you have any hospital stay? Was it a short stay or a prolonged stay? Did you have any complications in hospital or when you came out of hospital? Have you not felt right since you've left hospital? So these are very powerful key indicator. So let's look at some of the common drugs. I've written about this in Candida Crusher. This is on page 54 of Candida Crusher. Most common Western medicine risk factors involved in yeast overgrowth. Number one is medications. Yes, that's right. Medications, in my opinion, form one of the most important reasons why people get candida and maintain this candida condition for a long time. And of course, the top of the tree are the broad spectrum antibiotic drugs. I can't tell you how many thousands of people I've seen over the years that have never been well since taking antibiotics. And in some cases, these, you know, antibiotic courses have ranged from a simple 7 or 10 days on, say, penicillin up to 6 months plus. How crazy is that? So the broad spectrum antibiotics, in my opinion, are the number one cause, right up there in the top two or three causes, I should say, of candida. Anti-ulcer drugs, taking drugs to block, you know, acid formation in the stomach. We call them proton pump inhibitors or PPIs or acid blockers. These cause a huge amount of problem. They change the pH of the gut. They block acidity from occurring. This can allow bacteria to flourish in the area. This is going to create a lot of problems downstream, bloating and gas and malabsorption. It predisposes a person also towards a yeast infection. Corticosteroids, immune suppression drugs. This could be prednisolone tablets to swallow. This could be you may have been in hospital and had a course of dexamethasone or some kind of an intravenous steroid, you know, a powerful one. You may also be using topical steroid creams to put on the skin. All of these drugs are designed to suppress immune function. And when we suppress immunity, we increase susceptibility, you know, of getting sick. Diabetes drugs. There are many types of diabetes drugs, and often they will manipulate or influence insulin levels in the body. When you start playing around with these, you're a sitting duck for a yeast infection. Many, many people with diabetes on medications end up with candida infections. Immunosuppressive drugs, we've talked about them. There are more. There are many, many more different types of immunosuppressive drugs you can go on. You can also go on other drugs I see, particularly, for example, people with very bad joint pain. They may get put on methotrexate, for example, to suppress the pain. We see that with psoriatic arthritis or rheumatoid arthritis. And these drugs can also, of course, predispose you towards candida. Intravascular catheter use. You know, some people have to use catheters either for urinary infections or for many other reasons. And again, you're predisposed to bacterial or fungal infection. Or contraceptive pill use. I've done videos on this. Taking synthetic estrogen encourages, in many cases, the production of you know, inappropriate glycogen responses, sugar release in the body. Estrogen has many different effects which can predispose towards yeast infection. So people taking the pill need to be very careful. And of course, we spoke about prolonged hospital stay. So these are some very powerful predisposing factors and key indicators for yeast infection. This is video number one. Be sure to catch up with me in video number 2. Thanks for tuning in.